Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are doing chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. In that we are doing topic Types of Venation. When I say venation, it is nothing but the arrangement of veins present on leaf. Imagine a mango leaf and a peepal leaf. There's a difference, right, in the veins. Today we'll be studying about that. Venation. When I say venation, if you consider two different leaves, a mango leaf and a peepal leaf, there's a difference, right, in the shape, in the structure. There's a difference in the veins also. Venation is nothing but it is the arrangement of veins or veinlets in the lamina, or you can say the leaf plate. Venation could be of two different types. One is the parallel venation and the next form is reticulate venation. When I talk about parallel venation, in this type of venation, the veins run parallel to each other, or you can say they run perpendicular or at 90 degrees with each other. An example of this is the mango leaf. You have always noticed in that the veins are running parallel to each other, or you can say the veins meet at a common point. Whereas in reticulate venation, what happens is the veins, or you can say the veins, never run parallel to each other. They are somewhere interconnected to each other, but there are formation of different veins and veinlets which are crisscrossed among themselves. An example of this is the peepal leaf, which has reticulate venation. You can see number of veins and veinlet arising from the midrib, whereas in the case of parallel venation, from the midrib, or you can say the mid vein, the veins which arise are almost perpendicular. But in the case of peepal leaves, from the midrib of the leaf the veins arise, they can be zigzag or in crisscross manner. Types of venation. Venation is nothing but the arrangement of veins or veinlets in the lamina of a leaf. Venation could be of two types, parallel venation and reticulate venation. When we talk about reticulate venation, in this the veins run irregular or in parallel to each other. They are distributed just to form a mesh-like network, or a network which is crisscross. An example of this is the peepal leaf. In the case of parallel venation, what happens is the veins basically run parallel to each other, or they are at 90 degrees to each other. There is an interconnection due to the veinlets or the smaller section of the veins, but in parallel venation the veinlets are unbranched. They don't have a mesh-like network. They are just parallel to each other. An example of this could be a mango leaf. In this diagram, we can notice the two different types of venation. One is the parallel venation and another one is the reticulate venation. You can see in the parallel venation, veins run parallel to each other. Whereas in reticulate venation, the veins are irregular and they form a mesh-like network. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about what is venation and what were the two different types of venation, parallel venation and reticulate venation. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.